How does your garden grow, Mary?
Kia ora, everybody. Welcome back to Tarangi Farm. And today we're going to be talking about carrots. And here we've got Rebecca. And Danielle. And Hamish.
Yeah.
And James.
And James. Now, we're planting in a container this time because with a container, you can place it quite high up and the terrible carrot fly doesn't fly high, so it will miss them. Otherwise, if you're planting them in the ground, you can plant onions around them and the carrot fly gets confused by the smell of onions and leaves your carrots alone. So what Rebecca's doing right now, she's aerating the soil. She's digging just holes around the very well sifted soil. We've got a composted mix of topsoil and compost. We've got no manure. If you put even aged manure in, you'll find your carrots will do left and right turns and they'll get hairy taproots. And that's not what we're looking for in a carrot. They don't like lots of nitrogen, so more potassium-based fertilizers. The other good thing about having them in the container is once they've grown and they're getting closer to harvest, we'll bring them over to the house and then we can just get carrots when we like. You can leave carrots in the soil right through the year. We've had our last lot. This is the just finished our last lot, and that was in there for a year, just taking carrots out when we needed. They're frost resilient. In fact, carrots like to have frost because it improves the taste. When you get to the end of the season and they are ready to harvest and you want to leave them in the soil, just put a big mulch over them, maybe 18 inches high of hay or leaves that you've gathered because it's autumn. So what Rebecca's doing now is she's digging a furrow along. She'll do two of those in this bed. And not too deep, sweetheart, because they're tiny little seeds. And then she'll do another second row. You take them with your finger between two fingers and or do that. That's even better. So he's just sprinkling those in along the furrow, and Hamish and Danielle, you get yours in and just spread them out as much as you can. I always buy my seeds for carrots because they don't last. They need to be fresh, otherwise they're just not viable. Now guys, just gently put the soil over and cover them up. Now what we have to do now is we've got to take this brick, and when the kids have done that, James is going to press down on like that, and he's going to press them down because the seeds need to connect with the soil to germinate. They're quite, I found them quite slow germinating. I think the ones last year, I didn't think we were going to germinate at all, and then suddenly they did. But this year, they have been a lot quicker and a lot better. Okay, that's good. Now, what we'll do now is we'll go over and see the carrots we've previously prepared. Or did they say? We've prepared earlier. Okay, so here we are over at the raised bed, and we've got some carrots that I planted probably about 6 weeks ago. And we could have thinned them at 4 weeks, but I quite like to thin them when they're little baby carrots, like you're really thinning them. Just go in and just wriggle them around a bit. Choose the ones that you want to thin out. But thinking about it, thinking what you're looking at, you're wanting to get the carrots that are in the middle of the clump so that you're good, so that you're making room for the other carrots to get bigger. Oh. So Rebecca, let's have a wee think about that one. If you were thinning them when they're about 4 weeks old, it's quite a good idea not to pull them out, but actually just to snip the tops off with a pair of scissors, because then you're not disturbing the roots. The roots now hopefully are a bit stronger, so you can pull them out and then have the fun of actually eating them. We've got a second lot of carrots growing. We've planted those about 2 weeks afterwards, and they're blooming. And then we'll plant this lot, and hopefully that will keep us going for a little while, but we'll keep sowing them. Okay, so thank you, and we hope we'll see you later.
And subscribe.